Now I'm going to make a Stilton soup, and I'm starting off by frying the onion, not to a brown stage, just to a pale golden. So I've got 2 ounces of butter here, and I'm frying 2 onions, about 8 ounces, and I've sliced those. And you want to let them take on this very pale colour. Don't let them get dark, because it'll colour the soup. Then here I've got the Stilton soup. This is the, was rather a dry piece of Stilton, so it's a good way of using it. And just take the Stilton and crumble it. The easiest way of crumbling it is just to take it off like this. There we are. Press it down. I'm not going too near the rind, because if you do, it'll be a little bit bitter. So I'll discard the rind. Now add the Stilton to the fried onion. Now at this stage, it can catch quite easily, so keep stirring it and let it melt. And it will do it quite easily. Press it down. Crumble it up even into smaller pieces. I have tried making this with a Danish blue cheese, but I found it just a little bit too salty. It's really rather nicer with Stilton. Now that has become dissolved. There's a few big bits at the bottom. Then add the flour. And for the 2 ounces of butter, you add 2 ounces of flour. That's 2 rounded tablespoons. 1, 2. As you know, I never get the scales out for a small amount. Then stir that. So that's the roux method. Work that in. And at this stage, it's a thick roux. And see that it doesn't stick to the bottom. So it's a thick roux at this stage. And then slowly work in the stock. I'm just going to draw that to one side while I show you the stock. Now, I've got a good chicken stock here. But there's some fat that's risen to the top, so I'm going to take that fat off. And it comes off beautifully, just take it off. And that's very useful to have for frying, for any dish, such as if you're making a white sauce, you could easily make it with this. So I'll just trim it down and keep that, and keep it in the fridge. Then to the stock. Now this is a really lovely jellied stock. That's just as it should be. As my mother says, you should be able to jump on it. Then add the stock. And add it little by little. Now that stock is such a good colour because I reduced it. You remember I was saying make the stock, and once you've made it and take the bones off, you can boil the stock rapidly. You'll get a bit of a steamy stitched kitchen, but it's well worth it because you'll get a nice concentrated stock. Now work that in, and it'll take about 10 minutes to add that stock in, and keep stirring all the time, and be very careful that it doesn't stick on the bottom. Now, as that would take 10 minutes, I've got one on the front of the cooker, and I'll show it to you. So I'll draw that to one side and finish it in a moment, and turn the heat down. Now to the one that I've got ready. It smells very good. Now, the one thing I didn't do was, because I hadn't put all the stock in, was to add the bay leaf. Now, I've added a bay leaf to this one, and it has simmered for 20 minutes. I brought it to the boil and then simmered it, and so I'm going to remove that bay leaf. Let's just see that consistency. First find the bay leaf. I can just see it there. It's a bit like finding the... There we are, there's the bay leaf. Remove it, it'll have given the flavour, and it's ready for to serve. Add cream, and the cream, you use single cream, and only add it just before serving, so 1/4 pint of single cream. Don't boil it after having added the cream, just stir it in. I'm going to do that again with the ladle so you can see. Just whip mix it until it's well blended. Don't slop it on the cooker like me. I'll move it to one side and I'll put it on the board and move it over here. And then to add a little bit of colour, you can put a little bit of chopped parsley over the top. Now, I keep my chopped parsley in a jar in the refrigerator because I find it very useful to have on hand if you're doing quite a bit of cooking. Say you've got friends for the weekend and you don't want to set to and chop little bits of parsley, you can keep it in a screw-top jar like this for 2 or 3 days. Now let me give you the recipe. 2 ounces of butter, 8 ounces of onion, finely sliced, and you cook those together until the onion is just tender. 6 ounces of Stilton, crumbled, and you can do this with a fork. 2 ounces of flour. 2 pints of chicken stock, and you add the stock slowly to the other ingredients. When you've added all that, add a bay leaf, season it with salt and pepper, and cook it for about 20 minutes. Then, when it's ready, add cream, 1/4 pint, and it will serve 6 people. And now to tasting that Stilton soup. That's fine. Take care you don't add too much salt, because the Stilton could well be salty. And do stir it all the time you're cooking it, because it's very apt to catch. Now some good things to go with soup. Well, I expect you've already made croutons, just little fried bread cubes, and they're simply lovely. Now, Melba toast, not everybody makes that, and it's so easy. Just toast bread, and while it's still hot, trim off the crust, and you must do this while it's hot, otherwise you won't be able to split it. Take a sharp knife and split down the middle while it's still warm, quite easy. You need thin sliced bread, right down, having split them in half, then cut them in half, and then you'll find in the middle, you just put those under the grill for a few moments, and they will curl up and look like this, and they'll keep well in a tin. Then we've got French bread with a lovely cheesy topping. That's cheese, butter and garlic mixed together, spread on bread and toasted. And then we've got pinwheels. Take white bread and spread it with herb butter. That's butter and fresh herbs. And of course we all know about cheese straws. They're very good too. Now how about freezing all of these? Well, they all freeze except for the French bread.